Welcome to this brief guide on how to count visible rows in a filtered range. If you have ever tried counting the number of rows in a range, you have likely relied on one of the count-based formulas. Unfortunately, this doesn't work very well if you then need to filter the range down to a subset of your data. Luckily, today I'm going to walk you through an easy-to-replicate method to make this possible for you. And what's more is that this method works in both Google Sheets and Excel. Here I have a large workbook open in Sheets that contains a recap of my team's 2023 sales data. It has well over 1,000 entries in it. The column I am going to be focusing on for this demonstration is the Net Promoter Score column here at the end. I'm looking to gauge how well my team is performing in each of the different sales regions, and so I have built a second sheet with an NPS calculator specifically for this purpose. To make things a lot easier to understand throughout this demo, I have selected the entire column for the NPS score data and given this range a name of NPS score. Check out my previous video on named ranges for a walkthrough of this feature. Let's now pivot over to my NPS calculator sheet and see how it works. I can see that the current Net Promoter Score for my team as a whole across 2023 is sitting at 42. Looks like there's a bit of improvement needed here. The calculator is using the score data here for this calculation. It relies on the count if formula to find out how many of each survey response we have received in our NPS score column. We can see here that there have been 365 responses of 10 on our entire data set. But now we head back to our data set to start filtering to a specific sales region. I'm going to filter the range so that only the East sales region is being displayed. I'm excited to see the NPS score for just the visible rows here. Unfortunately, when I jump back to my calculator sheet, we see that the numbers have not changed. It is still showing the data for the entire dataset and not the filter that I wanted it to. We're going to fix this with the addition of another column to our table. Firstly, we ensure that our data is unfiltered and then add an additional column to the side of our dataset. This is going to be our helper column. Our helper column is going to use a formula called the subtotal formula. The subtotal formula can do numerous things, ranging from average and count formulas all the way through to standard deviation and variance formulas. Entering 103 here will perform a count A on the cells, but only for the visible cells. And the range we will be checking against is the first cell in our range. This way, we will get a result of 1, but only on rows that are visible. Google Sheets will then give us the option to quickly autofill this formula to the entire column. I'll use the keyboard shortcut to do this now. This column is the key to making our formulas work as we want. I'm just going to give this column the name of helper so that updating our formulas in a moment will be easier. And one of the best things about this is that we don't even need this column to be visible in order to use it. We can keep our table looking clean and tidy by hiding this column. And now all we need to do is make some updates to our NPS calculator formulas to take this helper column into account. This involves changing from a count if formula, which only takes into account one criteria, over to a count if S formula. This allows us to designate multiple criteria to be taken into account. For our second criteria, we tell it to check the helper column for a result of 1. This works as any hidden cells will no longer show 1. We then fill this formula down so that the entire table follows the same formula to show the number of respondents for each different NPS score option. Lastly, we need to also update our cells that are aggregating the number of promoters, the number of detractors, and lastly, the number of passives among our survey results. This also just involves converting these over to count if S formulas so that they can take our helper column into account, just like our first column of data. And now this is where the magic happens. We head back over to our sales dashboard sheet and filter the data set so that we only see the results for our East sales region, head back to our NPS calculator, and success! We are now only seeing the count for the number of visible rows in our filtered data set. This means that I can now see my East sales region has a lower NPS score than the average. And if I then go back to my data set and change the filter over to the Central sales region instead, I can see that they are in fact performing even worse than the East region in regard to NPS. And lastly, switching to the North sales region now, I can see that they seem to be performing markedly better than the other regions and lifting the team average as a result. And whilst I have only been filtering by region in this example, this would also work regardless of what column I used to filter my range of data. And that is how you use the subtotal formula to count rows in a filtered range in Google Sheets. I hope you found this guide valuable and it saves you plenty of time in the future. And I'll catch you in my next video. Thanks for watching. If you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to check out the channel. And if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button.